Well, good morning again, everyone. So good to be with you. I start today by just talking about a gap that exists in our world, in our society, between the haves and the have-nots. That gap seems to continue to be growing instead of lessening. And what a tragedy that is. Here we are 2,000 years after the time of Jesus and the gospel message that we heard today and all the other messages we hear from God's word. And, you know, we're still at an uncomfortable and tragic kind of direction in our lives as we live in relationship with one another or fail to live in relationship with one another. I go back, though, to that first reading from Proverbs. There aren't a whole lot of stories about women in the scriptures, and I love this one. And, you know, it's about a mother. It's about a wife. It's about just, and we just heard a few verses of chapter 31 in Proverbs, but it's just a very rich story of this woman who had this sense of the gifts that she had that she believed really came from God and understood that they came from God, these skills that she had. And she took those and she used them for her own family in different ways and then for others. And the text even said, and especially for the poor and the needy, because she seemed to be fairly well off. And yet she was very industrious and very conscientious about her responsibility to share and to use those gifts and talents and whatever she had with those around her. And she did such a good job, lived so very heroically in all of that. The gospel today, of course, is an interesting story too, which we've heard so many times, huh? The story is often called the parable of the talents. Jesus tells the story. And those that received and those that were to use those talents. Now, the talents here, that's a word for money, a form of money, an amount of money. Talent was quite a bit of money, as a matter of fact. But often, you know, you and I use the word in relation to our gifts that we have, you know, our abilities that we have. And that's not a bad translation either. So I would even prefer we not look at this as a story about money, as about God's gifts to us, you know, in all kinds of different ways, you know, time, talent, treasure, those three things especially. And how in this story, you know, as we interpret it in that broader sense of talent, the bottom line is God gives us various gifts and we are stewards and caretakers, you know, of those gifts. He then challenges us to use and to share those gifts with and for others, and especially with the needy, with the poor, and with others that are around us. He wants us to reach out, to do service, you know, for others, and do that with, as I say, our time, talent, and treasure. We're never gonna be sorry doing that. There was a time in my life when I thought, you know, when I give something away, then it's gone. Only the interesting thing about how God has written the story, and I'm not talking this story, I'm talking about our life story, is that the more we give, the more we receive. The more we pour out to others, the more we get in return. How often have I in my priesthood heard people in my parishes that I've been at and the work that I've done say, you know, I've done this, not bragging, just talking about their commitments and how blessed they felt. You know, they gave away their time, their talent, and even their treasure, and they got so much back for it because that's the way God works. That's a further blessing that God adds to our life. And to have a sense of that, is so important to look at ourselves when we have been giving, serving, pouring out. We always come back with something more than what we gave out, truly. And we're not talking you gave out $100 and you got $100 or more back, but you got some other kind of gift that fills your life. And so it's so needed, it's so necessary for us to take these things. First of all, number one, realize they come from God initially. Even though you put in some blood, sweat, and tears, they come from God. And so we should be so ready and easily able to go out and give it away. You know, when somebody gives you a gift, real deliberately in your life, somebody just gave me a gift. I live in a senior center, and one of the ladies just gave me a scarf that she, I don't know the difference between knitting and crocheting and so on. But anyway, she made this scarf for me and gave it to me now that it's getting cold out, so that I could wrap that around my neck and protect myself from the cold, the wind, and so on. And so she gave me this gift. Well, Ralph Gross, you know, kind of owns about 10 different scarves, and some of them are the kind that I can wrap around a couple times, you know, and they still hang 2 feet, 3 feet, 4 feet down on my stomach. And so I really don't need this particular scarf. I hope she's not here today. I really don't need this particular scarf, but she gave it to me, and after a little while, I'll probably give it to somebody else, and it'll be real easy to do, you know? But, because I didn't put anything in receiving that, and but yet, we need to understand that's not just what we should give away or how we should give things away. It's that everything we have is really gifted to us by our God. The time, the talents we've got, the skills we've got, and even the money that we have, that we've worked for, is still a gift from God. So when our Master, our God, calls us to give an accounting, as this master in that parable did, and by the way, as we heard in that second reading today that Bob did shared with us from Thessalonians, we don't know the time, the day, and the hour, you know, when the Lord's going to call us, when the Lord's going to ask for an accounting. And that can come any moment. So I just over the last week buried somebody that's much younger than I am. We better be prepared. We better be prepared to show how generous we have been with this time, talent, and treasure that God has gifted us with. And then there's another piece that I just think is important, and it has to do with that woman in the first reading from Proverbs, and it is the example that she gave. I'm inspired by the example of other people who are generous and good and giving and serving and so on. And we need to be conscious of not, again, doing things for showing off or a pride kind of thing, but we really need to be generous with our time, talent, and treasure, and to do it as a good example for other people. It inspires, it very much inspires others. I talk about a situation in a money-raising commitment thing that I was doing at a parish, and I just watched different people get up and make commitments of their time and also some of their money, and it inspired other people in that group that had been called together in a special way to be the forerunners of this campaign that we were going to do. And they, again, really helped to lead one another to much more generosity. So I end with this, you know. First of all, if you're doing things like this, and we all are, I say bless you in your service, you know. And God is blessing you in your service. And then thanks to those who've been trying to really live this gospel, you know, in their daily life. As I said to the youngsters as they were leaving, you know, this word that they were going to break open, this scripture that they were going to break open is inspired by the Holy Spirit. It's God's word. This isn't, you know, the sports page. It isn't a well-written novel. It's so much more than that. And to be able to live that and act on it and live by it, you know, is going to be a tremendous blessing in our life. Let's celebrate that. Let's continue to work at that.